Hello friends, today in this video I have to tell you that how to manage your stocks, your inventory system in our POS system. Now I will guide you step by step how to maintain, so please see the video carefully that you can maintain your inventory very well. So let's start from here. First of all, we have to make that, basically you all know that we have to fill our restaurant info, kitchens, categories, menus, item, you all very well known. Now we have to going to maintain our stock. So first we have to make our warehouse. This is a warehouse type, means to say like we have a one warehouse system or two warehouse. Like example, you have a veg warehouse, where you have put your veg products and there is a non-veg warehouse where you have to put your non-veg items. Now second option is warehouse. Where is the warehouse located, or you can name that warehouse systems. I'm giving a simple example, vegetable house. And this is a veg warehouse system, non-veg. And you can write here your address of your warehouse also. You can save it. Now you can make other, suppose non-veg. Yes, suppose chicken house, and that is, and you have to return and address. Now after making your the warehouse systems or warehouse type, we have to make next step, we have to create our raw material. Raw material means to say we have to create here raw items like vegetables, chickens, which we bought from the market to cook in your kitchens. So I give you a little simple example. First we have to create a vegetables item, suppose potato, and this will category, you have to make that a category, vegetable category. If you want any description, want to, you can give unit. That is in kg, price suppose $20, and there is a reorder point. Reorder point to means to say when there your stock is going to less, or you, when you have to select set here your reorder point. Suppose you have to set a reorder point on 2 kg. When your stock going to below 2 kg, then there is a pop-up window showing that your stock is going to negative, then you can give order easily. Suppose we have to make put, and if you have any opening quantity, you can put it or just leave it, just add it here and save. Now we have to make to next item, potato. That is in vegetable, that is also in kg. We have to reorder point and warehouse. We have to select on which warehouse these items we have to put. Add here and save. Now we have to make new items. Suppose mutton. That we have to put in mutton category. Unit in kg. Price 60 and reorder point. You have to select in which warehouse you have to put this item. Then one more item we have to make, like chicken, and we have to put it in chicken category. Unit are in kg and 80 and reorder point 2. We have to select from here chicken house and save. Okay. Now after creating a raw material, you can see that this we are going to create a raw materials which we bought from the market. Now I am going to create our supplier. Supplier means to say from where we have to purchase the raw materials like fruits, vegetable, from cash to credit order. If you are going to purchase in a credit, you are a credit customer of your supplier, then you have to create a customer here. Suppose Muhammad or suppose Asif Ali. Address Mall Town, you can pin code here, their mobile number, email ID, VAT number, PAN, which details you have, you can put it here and save it. After making the supplier account, you can see here, you can add it here, supplier account, and you can search your suppliers by name, cities, contact number from any one of them. Now we have to go to make a purchase entry, from where you have to select the customer or supplier from where you have bought the items. Now that is zero balance. Now product name is chicken, warehouse in chicken house, and quantity, suppose you bring 50 kg, total amount always is showing you. Now next item, that is mutton, 20 kg, you have added. Now potato is a vegetable that like this, you can see that, and here there is an option that you bring credit or cash, you can select it and just save it. If you bring credit, you can easily see the statement of your supplier, you can see the reports from here. When you have to going to select the supplier, automatically show the balance, or you want to see the reports of your supplier, you can easily show, just select your You can see the report. This is a Asif Ali report. If you want to make the payment to the Asif Ali, just go to payment and select your supplier. And if you want to make him cash, check, online transfer, any option already. If you are giving him my, if you see that there is a balance 5600, but you are going to pay 4000, then you have to put it and easily check the ledger of your supplier. If you want to see the ledger, that what amount it pending, you can see it easily. Now we have to going to already giving you, so we have to now to see the watch the stock item, what stocks in our warehouse system. This is a warehouse which you have to 50 kg chicken house. Chicken house, you can see that easily with vegetable house, how much items are there. So this is all the reporting system. This is how you have can maintain your warehouse, you can maintain your supplier, and you can maintain your supplier management and purchase entry. Thank you. Now in our next video, we have to tell you that how we have to make transfer the items in the kitchen and how we make a recipe. Thank you. Have a nice day.